Hi everyone, my name is Michelle Kenny and I'm part of the Family Place Libraries team. In this tutorial, we want to go through the steps of the recertification form with you. First, you will visit our Family Place Libraries website at www.familyplacelibraries.org. This is our homepage. Please click on the member login link located on the right. Next, you will be asked for your username and password. This was emailed to the primary contact person we have listed for your library. If you don't know your login, please send us over an email and we can get that right over to you. If you just forgot your password, please click on the Reset Your Password link and an email will be sent to the primary contact's email address we have on file and you can follow the prompts from that email. Once you have your username and password, you can log in. Once you logged in, this is what you will see. We are only going to go through the recertification form that you can find on the right-hand side. If you have questions about other parts of the member dashboard, visit our other tutorial where I will walk you through the entire dashboard. All right, let's get started. Click on the link that says your library name on the right side. From here, we are going to go through filling out each of the fields of the recertification. Library name, address, and phone number will be auto-filled for you based on the information we received at the time of your library staff attended our training. We also filled in the primary contact person's name and email address that we have in our records. Please check for accuracy of the pre-filled information, then proceed to edit and fill in the rest of this page. You can either click on Next or you can save your progress so that you don't lose any of your information. Clicking on Save Your Progress will bring you to this screen, and in order to get back to continue to fill out your form, you will click on Edit. I don't want anyone to panic. This will bring you back to the first page of the recertification form. All you have to do is scroll down to the bottom of the screen and click Next to get to the page you left off on. Next, you will be asked to fill out information on your parent-child workshop. Some of you may call this workshop something different. For example, 1, 2, 3, Play With Me, Play, Learn, and Grow, TLC, etc. Please make sure to fill out all this information to the best of your ability. Next, we will fill out additional programming. This is where you can highlight some of those wonderful programming you have been doing in addition to the parent-child workshop. This is for ages birth through 5, and add in those parenting programs you've been doing as well, such as sensory programs, story times, support groups for your parents. Now let's fill in the section about your space you have on your public floor. We're talking about the toys that are accessible on your public floor during normal library hours. Tell us how many patrons, little and big, visit your early childhood space each month. This does include all children and adults. Parents collection. Do you have one? Is your parents collection located near your early childhood area? Please fill in these questions and move on to the next step. We're almost there, everyone. We will now fill out information about your collaborations and partnerships. We like to see who you're using for your parent-child workshop, resource professionals, and other organizations that might help with other services. For example, we listed our resource professional, a Head Start board that one of our librarians sit on, and also talked about our partnership with the Family Service League to provide support to our families. Up next is outreach. Highlight any outreach efforts you have made this past year. For example, we discuss in our recertification form about the parent-child home program and Kids in Care, which are both efforts of reaching as many little patrons as possible with visits to their homes and home daycare facilities. Next is trained staff. Please tell us who is currently staffed at your library and has attended the Family Place Institute training. Let us know if you would be interested, now or down the road, to send more staff to training. Lastly, provide any additional training staff has attended this year. For example, we put NAEYC webinars and the Parent-Child Home Program Conference. The next two steps are the most important and might require some thought. They are the overview for your library about how Family Place has impacted your community this past year. We then require a picture or two of your early childhood space and your parent-child workshop. Both of these things will be shown when someone clicks on your library from our location section on our website. Once you submit your information, this is how your library's information will look on our website for all to see. If there are any patrons in your pictures, please make sure to have a signed photo permission slip from them since this will be on a website for everyone to see. Well, that's everything. We hope this tutorial was helpful, and if at any time you have any questions, don't hesitate to email or give us a call. We look forward to seeing everyone's recertification form and seeing the great impact you're having on your community. Thank you.